Do you watch the news that we're watching in the United States? Do you see what we're hearing about the war? Do you?
No.
So we might actually know everything.
If I were to watch the news that you're hearing in the United States, yes, I'd just blow my brains out because it would drive me nuts.
Really?
Yeah.
It's as though we've become numb. Yeah. I mean, there were 51 people killed today in a Shia neighborhood in Iraq. Are we just numb? Have we lost our humanity with this entire situation?
Yeah, we have. You know, I was asked once, do you feel responsible for the American public having a bad view, a negative view of the war in Iraq? And I looked at the reporter and I said, tell me the last time you saw the body of a dead American soldier. What does that look like? Who in America knows what that looks like? Because I know what that looks like. And I feel responsible for the fact that no one else does. You know? That's what I feel responsible for, that nobody really understands. And the soldiers do feel forgotten. They do. No doubt, from Afghanistan to Iraq, they absolutely feel, you know, it hasn't, we may be tired of hearing about this 5 years later. They still have to go out and do the same job. I was in Sutter City when it was just going absolutely hell for, I mean, Sutter City was like Armageddon. And there were soldiers that had been in country 9 months, had never seen combat like that. Just thrown into it, didn't, you know. You're talking about convoys ambushed with 5, 6 armor-piercing bombs, rocket-propelled grenades, right, everything. 9, 10, 15-hour battles.
And it's something that we might get just a brief glimpse of on the news, or just a mention and that kind of thing. Well,
and more soldiers died in Afghanistan last month than Iraq. Who's paying attention to that? 33,000, highest troop levels since the war began, 7 years after we defeated the Taliban.
Well, it's certainly, it, you know, it's...